Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we'll go over the circular reference error in Excel. So a circular reference is a type of error in Excel that happens when a formula in a cell tries to calculate itself. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to this channel for even more tips. For example, a common way of ending up with a circular reference error is by accidentally including the cell that should contain the formula result as part of the formula. So let's say I want to add these two numbers and see the result in cell B4. And perhaps I'm in a hurry, and in my rushing, I accidentally include cell B4 in the sum formula. The first thing that happens is we get an error alert from Excel. So once we read it and click OK, notice the result is zero. That's clearly wrong. Excel defaulted to this because of the circular reference error. The error kept it from correctly adding our two cells. Another way we can tell we have a circular reference error is by the note here at the bottom left of our spreadsheet. We can also confirm which cell has the error by looking in the Formulas tab. In the error checking, click on the down arrow and then go to circular references, and this will show you which cell has a circular reference error. Before we fix the first example, let's say we accidentally type a second circular reference error. This time we want to calculate a tax of 5%. Now instead of multiplying the cost of the item by 5%, we accidentally multiply the total by 5%. We again get a result of zero because of the circular reference error. Notice that this time we did not get an error alert from Excel. That's because you only get the alert once per session. Also, a couple of other things. Notice the little blue arrows back and forth. That's letting us know that these two cells are trying to calculate each other. So the tax is trying to calculate 5% from the 100, and the 100 is trying to include this number in its sum. Now before we go on, in the error checking, notice that when we check the locations, we only see the location of one of our errors, and that was the one in B4. So as we fix these, and we'll fix this one by revising the sum formula to only include cells B2 and B3, when we go back, notice that it went on to give me the locations of the next circular reference errors. So if we now fix this one, notice that the errors completely went away. Now, if we'd had more errors, obviously that would continue until all of them had been fixed. For the most part, the best course of action is to change the cells used in your formulas to avoid this error. But if what you're working on requires you to calculate a circular reference, go into your Excel file options, and in Formulas, check off Enable Iterative Calculation. This will force Excel to calculate and recalculate to help solve your formula. It's important to be cautious when selecting this option because once selected, it will apply to all your spreadsheets, meaning you may not notice an accidental circular reference error as Excel will try to calculate a result. You could end up with an incorrect result and not realize it. So make sure to use this option with care. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on circular references in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.